Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you shape sublayers and vector layers in the .NET MAUI Maps control. I'll demonstrate how to add sublayers to both the tile layer and shape layer, and how to customize their appearance. Additionally, I'll show you how to add various vector layers to the maps. First, I open an existing MAUI application, where I have already configured the necessary maps namespace and added the MAUI Maps control with map tile layer. If you want to learn how to add maps to an app, I recommend watching the Getting Started video linked in the card. You can also download the Getting Started example from the link provided in the description below. I'll run the application on an Android emulator. As you can see, the world map is rendered on the tile layer. To add sublayers, define the sublayers property. This property contains a collection of map sublayers. Within the sublayers collection, add a map shape sublayer element for actual geographical rendering. To load the desired shape from various sources, define the shapeSource property. In this example, I will assign the URL of Africa JSON to the shapeSource property. You can notice that Africa is highlighted on the map. If you want to add sublayers to the map shape layer, first remove the existing map tile layer and replace it with the map shape layer. Then, set the world map JSON data as the value for the shapeSource property. Finally, follow the same steps as mentioned earlier to add the map shape sublayer inside the sublayers collection. You can see that Africa is highlighted on the map shape layer. Now, let's see how to customize the appearance of the map sublayers. To change the color of a shape, define the shapefile property and set an appropriate color value. Furthermore, if you wish to customize the border of the shape, set the shapestroke and shapestroke thickness properties accordingly. Here, the shape color and border are customized on the sublayer. To apply colors to shapes based on specific values, you can use color mappings. In this example, the model class has already been bound, which includes information such as state, density level, count, color, and size. The state details have been added to the ViewModel class. To start, define the color mappings property in the shape sublayer to associate specific values with corresponding colors. For example, if you want to compare the density level, set the shape color value path property to density level to indicate that it will be used for color mapping. Bind the generated data to the dataSource property. Primary value path to state. And shape data field to name. Inside color mappings, add equal color mapping elements. For instance, you can include an element. Then, set its value to high and assign the color red. Similarly, add another element with low and green. You can observe that the shape sublayer is automatically colored based on the density level values. Also, you can apply colors to shapes based on a range of values by using the range color mapping instead of equal color mapping. Next, let me show you how to display data labels and customize their appearance. First, set the show data labels property of the map shape sublayer to true. And define the data label settings property. Inside that, add a map data label settings element. And set its data label path to state to specify what needs to be displayed in the labels. To customize the appearance of the data labels, define the data label style property
and assign it a map label style element.
Within the element, set attributes such as the text color, font size, and font weight. To demonstrate, I set the text color to red and make the font bold. Before running the application, I make sure to remove the color mappings and any shape customization codes I had previously added. Looking here, the data labels have red text color and bold font on the map sublayer. Now, let's see how to show bubbles and customize their appearance. Before starting, remove the code changes related to data labels in the shape sublayer. To show bubbles, set the show bubbles property to true. This will enable the display of bubbles on the desired location. Next, to customize the appearance of bubbles, define the bubble settings property
and assign it a map bubble settings element.
Within the element, set the color value path property to color to specify the color, and set the size value path property to size to define the size of the bubbles. Looking here, the bubbles are displayed on the map sublayer with their appearance customized as specified. Next, I'll show how to display tooltips. Remove the code changes related to bubbles in the shape sublayer.
To display tooltips, set the show shape tooltip property of the map shape sublayer to true. See, tooltips are visible when I tap the shapes.
To customize the appearance of the tooltips, define the shape tooltip template property
and provide a data template for the tooltips.
Inside this data template, add a horizontal stack layout to add two labels horizontally. Add the first label and set its text to state and text color to white. Similarly, add another label and bind the state property to its text property
and text color to white.
You can observe that the tooltips are displayed on the shape sublayers when you tap the shapes.
Now, to enable selection, I set the enable selection property to true.
Before running the application, remove the code changes related to tooltips. Once the map is loaded, you can tap on any shape, and you will notice that the selected shape is highlighted on the shape sublayer of the map. To customize the appearance of the selected shapes, set the selected shape fill,
selected shape stroke, and selected shape stroke thickness properties.
By setting these properties to the desired values, you can customize the fill color, and stroke thickness of the selected shape.
See, the appearance of the selected shape is customized.
Now let me show you how to add vector layers, such as a line, arc, polyline, circle, and more, to the map. These layers are considered sublayers. Now, I'll start by adding lines. I remove the existing map shape sublayer
and replace it with a map line layer within the sublayers collection.
To add multiple map lines, define the lines collection. Then I add a map line element, which connects two location coordinates through a straight line. In the element, specify the from property to set the starting coordinates using latitude and longitude. Similarly, define the to property to set the ending coordinate.
You can repeat this process to add multiple map lines.
As you can see, map lines are displayed on the map.
Now, let's see how to customize the appearance of map lines.
To change the color of the lines, set an appropriate color value to the stroke property. Similarly, to adjust the thickness, set an appropriate value to the stroke thickness property. You can repeat this process for each map line added. See, map lines are customized according to the specified color and thickness. If you want to apply animation to map lines, define the animation duration property in the map line layer and set an appropriate value, such as 3000. As you can see, map lines are animated accordingly. Similarly, you can add different sublayers to enhance the functionality and visual representation of the map's control. The map arc layer allows you to connect two location coordinates through a curved line.
The map polyline layer is used to add polylines on the map. The map circle layer allows you to create multiple circles at different locations. The map polygon layer is used to render multiple polygons. If you want to learn more about the map arc layer, map polyline layer, and map circle layer, refer to the documentation provided below. In this video, I have shown you how to add sublayers to both the tile layer and shape layer, and how to customize the appearance. I also demonstrated how to show data labels, bubbles, tooltips, and selected shapes on the shape sublayers. Furthermore, I showed how to add various vector layers. If you want to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link provided in this video's description. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.